Here we have a pretty classic limit question from Calculus 1. And I will tell you guys why this is tricky and then why students will get this wrong. First of all, let's see. When we put infinity into all the x's, because x is approaching infinity, so we just care about this and care about that, right? So it looks like we just have infinity minus infinity. And again, if you just ignore that part because x is infinity, and then likewise ignoring that part, they are exactly the same thing. So the answer is just equal to 0. That's it, end of the video. Of course not. I told you it's tricky already because the answer is not equal to 0. It's much more complicated. Well, a little bit more complicated. Let's continue to see why. First off, when we are doing limit, if we get infinity minus infinity, we cannot draw any conclusion yet. We cannot draw any conclusion yet because this is an indeterminate form. We don't know what the answer is unless we do more work. Well, we have square root. So let's go ahead and just use the conjugate. Let's multiply the top and bottom by square root of x squared plus ax and change the minus to a plus, and then we have the other square root, which is x squared plus bx. And of course, we divide the same thing here. So we have square root of x squared plus ax and then plus square root of x squared plus bx. Cool. And let's go ahead and multiply out the top. And let's still write down the limit as x approaching infinity. For the top, when we are multiplying out the conjugate, we can just square the first term, which we will just get x squared plus ax. That's the first term. And we will have to minus square the second. And in that case, you see, we see we have two terms inside. Let's go ahead and put down the parentheses. And we'll just put it inside here. The square root and square cancel already, so we just have to do x squared plus bx. And then of course the bottom stays square root of x squared plus ax and then plus square root of x squared plus bx. Work out the top, this is negative x squared minus bx, and then of course this and that cancel. Okay, now here's the deal. X is approaching infinity. So now, because we have a rational expression now, well, technically with a square root, but it's still like a fraction expression now, we can compare the dominating parts on the top and also on the bottom. For the top, we see that we have x, and we just have to do a minus b, and I'm going to factor out the x. So here we have the limit as x approaching infinity, and I will just write it as a minus b, and then we factor out the x at the end. For the bottom, we care about this, and we also care about that. This is going to give us x, and likewise, this is also going to give us x. And the reason that this is just a positive x is because x is positive infinity. We don't need to use the absolute value, all right? And on the bottom, we see that this together, we just get 2x. So x and x cancel out. Finally, we just get what? That answer, a minus b all over 2. All right? And in fact, if you know this little formula, you can do a lot of such limit questions with ease. For example, right? For example, I can say things like, what's the limit as x approaching infinity of, let's do this, square root of x squared plus 6x and then minus square root of x squared plus 2x. Well, you can go through the same thing again, or you can just remember the formula. Here, our a is 6 and then the b is 2. And by the way, a and b can be negative, but here they are both positive. So what do we do? 6 minus 2, which is 4, and then divided by 2. So the answer is equal to 2. Then we are done. Really cool in my opinion. And again, when we see infinity minus infinity, especially if you're just starting learning calculus, pay close attention to the indeterminate form. We cannot draw any conclusion when we see this. We must go through the computation like this one. If you need more help, check out my other videos. I have a lot more limit questions for you guys to help you guys with your Calculus 1 class. If you have any questions, leave them down below as well. That's it.